Almighty and everlasting God, who in the Paschal mystery established the new covenant of reconciliation, grant that all who have been reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A lesson from John chapter 20, verses 19 to 31. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. Here ends the lesson.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Faith is the assurance of things hoped for and the conviction of things not seen. So writes the anonymous author of the Epistle to the Hebrews. I imagine that whoever wrote Hebrews was inspired to supply that definition of faith because of their familiarity with the firsthand accounts of men and women such as Doubting Thomas. Thomas had not seen the risen Christ at this point, but only heard the good news from the other disciples that Jesus was alive. Faith came to Thomas as the assurance of things hoped for and the conviction of things not seen. Knowledge of Jesus as the risen Lord came to Thomas as it comes to us, by hearing and not by sight. Nobody saw Jesus rise from the dead. If the evangelists had wanted to mislead us, then surely they would have described a fantastic scene of Jesus' rising. But the evangelists were themselves faithful to the words of those who were there. Thomas, who had been told by the other disciples about their encounter with the risen Lord. Thomas did not see him again, and so too did others, Peter, John, and the women at the tomb. However, the message of that first Easter was received not by sight, but by faith. Surely there are some who will join us this morning that have heard the good news of salvation history and yet do not believe. You may join us, a convinced skeptic, or perhaps you believed once but find it difficult to trust in God after a lifetime with its fair share of disappointment. Or you are here because you want to feel something of the joy of Easter, the elation that tingles the spine as the choir sings a magnificent Alleluia descant. But as for faith, you'd rather not think too deeply about it. Or maybe, and I suspect this is the case with most of us. You come to church because you feel in some way obliged to be here, to keep the festal rites, to come to your church because that's what you do, as our parents and grandparents did before us. To all who come, the doubter, the devoted, the sinner, the lost, come, take your seat at the feast. It has become increasingly common for Christians to approach faith with a fundamentalism as if it is a matter of tangible feeling or verifiable fact. And while there are good reasons for faith, no reason or argument can convince anyone that Jesus rose from the dead. A life of faith may engender profound feelings of joy and belonging. Still, emotions are not meant to deaden our God-given reason. The great Puritan pastor William Perkins once assured a doubting soul who was convinced that because he didn't have faith, he would be damned, that the desire for faith is itself a sign of faith. After all, how can we desire that which we do not in some way know? Faith is the assurance of things hoped for and the conviction of things not seen. As the world lulls us into expecting only death and grief, faith comes as a surprise, not as a fact or a feeling, but as a gift. Not in whole, to be sure, but in part. We arrive with the women at a tomb dimly lit. He is not here. Come, see the place where he laid. One day we shall see him face to face. But this is Easter. We wonder at the gift that is before us. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness,
of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. We humbly pray you so to guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that all the cares and occupations of our life we may not forget you, but may remember that we are ever walking in your sight through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Amen.